Welcome to the intensity of success. What I'm finding is by doing right spiritual practice, everything that is false is leaving, is fleeing. Again this morning, another leaving, a fleeing from me of duality. The talking heads of duality, the high talk of duality left me this morning. I was in a dream this morning, left me. What happened was there were these talking heads like giraffes way up high getting the leaves, and I decided to focus in a clearing in the leaves, and I saw the Holy Spirit symbolized by this beautiful light, and like a dove, a beautiful light and a dove. And I said, that's the Holy Spirit. And these talking heads, immediately they left. They left me, gone. So that's like 4 days in a row now, at least, that some, you know, extremely heavy, delusional, fear-based complexes have left me. There's been an exodus away from me, from all this bad stuff that I don't want. I don't want it. It's leaving of its own accord. So this is what I have to report. This is very good news. In fact, there's only one good news. This plant, as it is the pure, great good news that I've been waiting for. This table, as it is the pure good news that I've been waiting for. This post, as it is the pure, pure good news that I've been waiting for. This day, as it is the great good news I've been waiting for in complete purity. That rock there, as it is the perfect good news I've been waiting for. That shrub there is the perfect good news I've been waiting for. The perfect good news that we've been waiting for is here today. It's here today. It's evident today. Everything else has gone away, leaving only the good news. Only the good news. Because everything here is actually an extension, a projection of our creativity through the medium of imagination. None of it comes from some separate God. None of it. Nothing at all has ever happened from any separate God that we think we created and been worshiping, thinking that this separate God is the one that's doing all this fighting, violence, death, disease, displacement, despair, struggling for survival, just this hideous play we've been putting on. We said it's coming from this God. No, it's coming from us. It came from us. Why is that good news? It's great good news. So nothing's ever happened as far as separation goes. Nothing has changed in reality. We've simply been imagining all of this, which means that we can see all of it this very moment as one, all abiding in the pure spaciousness that is God. That is the great good news, that everything is it has eternal life. There's only one eternal life. And when this dawns on us, we'll realize what great news it is, what very welcome news. There's only one good news. This plant is the good news that I've been waiting for. That stonework is the great good news that I've been waiting for. That hedge is the great good news that I've been waiting for. That sky is the great good news that I've been waiting for. That tree is the great good news that I've been waiting for. That leaf, that dead leaf there, is the great good news that I've been waiting for. There's only one good news. Only one good news. Nothing else is good news. Only the vision of oneness is good news. Nothing else is good news. There is no other good news other than to see the vision of oneness. that evaporates the bad news that we thought we're going to get. We think we're going to get some really bad news. It evaporates it. Gone. There is no bad news for us. Only the vision of goodness is it. Only the vision of oneness is good news. Everything else is a misperception. Out of whim, out of whim. Everything else is a whimsical misinterpretation. So our practice can be that that tree is the great good news that I have been waiting for. This air is the great good news that I've been waiting for. That plant just as it is the great good news that I've been waiting for. That driveway just as it is the great good news that I've been waiting for. I also remember this morning in a dream, I was in a room and I suddenly said, I don't want to go through this upcoming global problems, the world war and all this terrible stuff that's coming. I said, I just collapsed. I was sobbing. I said, I can't go through it. I simply cannot go through it. Having already gone through 57 years of absolute hell on this planet. I said, I don't want to go through the things that are going to happen on this planet. No way. But the remedy for that is the vision of oneness. That is the remedy. Where everything, no matter what the dance is, you realize it's our dance. It's not dance of someone else, something else. It's not the dance of something else. So we're completely in control of it, actually. And we can change the dance like that. You know, we're not trapped by anything. Everything that's happened, we are the ones that are causing this happening. We're the cause of it. There isn't some separate cause that we have no control over. Not at all. None. So this day is the great good news that I have been waiting for. This day, just as it is the great good news that I've been waiting for. So we're reaching the vision of oneness, and I can tell you for sure that those who've had the vision of oneness, who've abided in this, the events of the world did not affect them in the slightest bit. They remained in this pure bliss, no matter what was raging, world wars raging, none, didn't bother them in the slightest bit. So this is what we have to get to, because I'm sure many of us are very weary of all this bad news in the world. You know, all the bad news, the stuff. All news is bad news except the vision of oneness. The vision of oneness is the only good news there is. So put it this way, the vision of oneness is the only good news that there is. You see, that bad news about the economy has zero value to me. All the news is bad news except the vision of oneness. Only the vision of oneness is good news. And the vision of oneness is totally pure, and there's no exception to it. That bird, as it is the great good news. That road, as it is the great good news that I've been waiting for. That car, as it is the great good news I've been waiting for. That person, as it is the great good news that I've been waiting for. There's nothing outside of me. There's nothing outside of me. That is the great good news I've been waiting for. There is no separate will. That is the great good news that I've been waiting for. Now, again, in spiritual, right spiritual practice, it's helpful to have a coach, some coaching and some encouragement. Otherwise, we're not going to do it probably, because we really can't relate it. So well, we know it's talking about something, but you say, well, how does this relate to my everyday? It doesn't seem to relate, but what I've found is these deep-seated complexes that are causing us do not see the vision of oneness. They flee. When these spiritual exercises are like kryptonite to it, and they flee from us. It's like we turn in this kryptonite, and all these fear complexes, these terrible misperception complexes, they leave. They flee away as fast as possible. Like they can't stand this anymore. That is how it works. Okay, so don't look for direct success. In other words, when you do these exercises, don't say, well, where's the vision of oneness? How come it hasn't? First, these complexes flee away from you. That's what I'm experiencing. And when they've all fled, and I've had a lot of them flee away from me, then what is left is the vision of oneness. That's what's left. And there's nothing there to interfere with it anymore. So the interference has to leave, but you cannot drive it out by arguing. You drive it out by doing these exercises with conviction and purpose and determination. This is your will speaking. So it does take some faith, which is why the guru system was set up. The system of the saint system, guru system, where you had these beings showcasing vision of oneness and telling everyone, look, these exercises do work, will work for you, and then others follow that. But it's easy to get cynical about it if you say, well, where's the direct cause and effect? I don't see it. These deep-seated complexes we have, which distract us from the vision of oneness, they have to leave. They have to leave us. It's like rats deserting a ship that's going down or something, taking on water. Or people leaving a house that's on fire, fleeing the fire. But in this case, we're not on fire. We are simply insisting on that will is unified. There is no separate will. And it's the mechanisms of misperception that are fleeing. The complexes are fleeing from us. So we're putting on flea powder, and all the fleas are jumping off, and gotta get out of here. So no doubt, for those who do these practices, in some way in your dreams, in your daily life, somehow you'll realize that something has seemed to have no longer there. That was a big problem for you, that it's gone, just gone. And the key is to remain in the mood of repentance. I always say that. When these complexes leave you, you just continue in the humble mood of repentance. You don't jump into celebration mode too much. You say, okay, all right, that's gone, good. But no, try not to have no reaction to it. Just continue with your practices, that's all. You'll notice it, and you'll say, wow, that's a big milestone, but I don't have a vision of oneness yet, so I need to continue to practice. Don't go chasing after them with a camera. Don't try to find out where are they going to. No, just let them go. Keep practicing. Because you don't want them coming back, that's for sure. We are misperceiving what our problem is. Our projection, perception, personality, judgment misperceives what the problem is. So we're frantically working on this false problem. That's not the problem. And we're just wasting our time. Reason shows us what the problem is. And reason says, look, do these exercises, because that's directly targeting what the problem is. Vision of oneness is my only goal. It's the only goal there is. It's the only good news there is. It's the only value there is. Only the vision of oneness has value. This bad news has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Only the vision of oneness is good news. It's the only good news there is. It's the good news without a second good news. It's the one vision without a second vision. It's the all-inclusive vision without another. With nothing left out. Nothing is left out of this good news. This good news is total. Everything is included in this good news. The vision of oneness is the good news that I've been waiting for. This bottle, just as it is, this bottle as it is the good news that I've been waiting for. That mountain, as it is the great good news that I have been waiting for, is the all-inclusive good news that I have been waiting for. That tree is the all-inclusive good news that I've been waiting for. That cat is the all-inclusive good news that I've been waiting for. That cat, just as the all-inclusive good news that I've been waiting for. That bunch of flowers, as it is the all-inclusive great good news that I have been waiting for. There is no other good news. So when you see some news, you say that news about the Ukraine has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness is good news. And the vision of oneness is all-inclusive. Only the all-inclusive vision of oneness is good news. That news about Russia has zero value to me. Only the all-inclusive vision of oneness is good news. That news about the stock market has zero value for me. Only the all-inclusive vision of oneness is good news. That news about somebody winning the lottery has zero value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value for me. We can practice this way. Because we're so addicted to the news, aren't we? That's a terrible addiction, actually. There is no good news except the vision of oneness. The vision of oneness is the only good news there is. This is what we need to emphasize. So, this news about the drought has zero value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Only the vision of oneness is good news. The vision of oneness is all-inclusive, pure good news without any other news. This news about climate change has zero value to me. Zero value. There's no value to it. Only the vision of oneness has value. Only the all-inclusive, pure good news of the vision of oneness has value for me. All value is there. All inclusiveness is there. All good news is there. Only the vision of oneness is good news. There is no other good news. That tree branch, as it is the all-inclusive, pure good news that I have been waiting for, that I really want. That roof, just as it is the all-inclusive, pure, great, welcome, good news, which is what I've been waiting for. It's what I really want. What I want is good news. Only the vision of oneness is good news. Vision of oneness, the good is all-inclusive. There is no second vision. There is no second good news. There is no other good news. The vision of oneness includes all the good news that there is. What I really want is good news. Only the vision of oneness is good news. There is no other good news. That I really want. There is no other good news. This pathway is, just as it is the great good news that I have been waiting for. There is no other good news. This is it. This is the good news I've been waiting for. This is it. There is no other. There is no other this. There is no other good news. This is it right here. Just as it is, this is it. This, just as it is the great good news that I have been waiting for. This plant, just as it is the great good news that I've been waiting for. This day, just as it is the great good news that I've been waiting for. So we're turning up the heat on all these complexes of misperception, this vast complex that has been holding us spellbound in fear, turning the heat up on it. Not by dialectic words, but direct practice. This is what works. So I don't have a concrete wall problem, I have a continuity problem. That concrete wall is, just as it is the great good news that I've been waiting for. That ocean is the great good news that I have been waiting for, just as it is. There is no other good news. There is no other good news. That garbage dump, just as it is the great good news that I have been waiting for. That apartment building, just as it is the great good news that I've been waiting for. Those clouds, just as they are, that is the great good news that I've been waiting for. This planet, just as it is the great good news that I've been waiting for. The great good news without another, without a second. It's the all-inclusive great good news. This universe as it is the all-inclusive great good news that I have been waiting for. And what's that great good news? All of this, none of this is outside of us. None of it has ever been outside of us. It's all within our mind. It's all within our mind. There is no separate mind. There is no separate will that has been making any of this up, imagining any of this, making any of it, creating any of it. There is no separate mind. That's the great good news. And we don't realize at this point what great good news that is. It will bring this complete relief to us. And the dread that we've been desperately fleeing from and defending against, the dread is gone. So we don't need all these defenses. We only are left with just a continuity issue, and the vision of oneness resolves that for us. Those flowers, just as they are, that is the great good news that I have been waiting for. That is it. There is no other. There is no other good news. This is it. This is it. This is the great good news. Just this. Just this and not another. Just this and not another. Just this and not some other. So there's no reconciling that needs to take place. There's no integration that needs to take place. There's no compatibility that needs to take place. We don't have to try and make truth and lies true or compatible. The lie is based on nothing. There's nothing to substantiate the lie whatsoever. So it just collapses, it vanishes. There's nothing whatsoever to substantiate the lie of separation. So this now is the now that I've been waiting for. This now is the great good news I've been waiting for. This moment, just as it is specialness free. This moment, just as it is the great good news that I have been waiting for. There is no other. There is no other good news. This is the only good news there is. And it's all inclusive. It's here, this very moment. This moment, just as it is the great good news that I have been waiting for. This moment, just as it is the great good news that I really want. There is no other good news. It's all here, right now. All the good news is here, right now. It's like we're turning the heat up in the oven, gradually turning the heat, and all the rodents that have been hiding in the back in the oven and all the holes and everything, suddenly they scurry off, gone. Let them go. Don't chase them. Don't try to kill them. Don't try to chase them. It's enough that they're gone. Gradually turn the heat. We're just gradually turning the heat up. The more we turn the heat up, when you get some fugitive hiding somewhere, you're smoking them out and everything's quiet, nothing's happening, you think, wow, it's not working. And then suddenly they, oh, I can't stand anymore, and they run out. Run out of the house or something. These dark complexes in our oven, just suddenly. Suddenly scurry off. Suddenly, quickly they're gone. It's like, huh? It's a little startling, like, oh, huh? And then, but they're gone so fast that you hardly have time to react to it. So, as we turn this heat up, it may seem like nothing's happening. You say, what? Nothing's happening. And of course, the ego will say that, hey, there's nothing happening. Just keep turning the heat up. Keep turning the heat up. As fast as you can turn the heat up, as much as you can tolerate. Keep turning it up. And you may just be, 2 minutes away from some big fear complex just suddenly fleeing from you. Can't take it anymore. Can't take the heat anymore. But don't waste time in thinking about, well, how close am I? Because then you stop practicing. The ego's very good at that. Of saying, hey, you're really close. And then how close are you? Well, it could be just, I don't know, maybe a day away, or may get it today. And you're thinking about that. That's turning the heat down. You're starting to turn the heat down. So keep turning the heat up. Everything that can't take the heat leaves. What can take the heat? Holy Spirit, the vision of oneness. So, I don't have a bad news problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a bad news problem. I have a continuity problem. The bad news problem has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness has value. so we can practice in that way too, is that all this bad news has no value for me. Only the vision of oneness, which is the only good news there is, has value for me. So I want good news. Where do I go? For the vision of oneness is the good news. There is no other good news. We have spent a lifetime seeking for good news in the wrong places. It's like the song, looking for love in all the wrong places. We've been seeking good news in all the wrong places. We look at the newspaper, we turn on the television, looking in books and magazines and the internet. We're seeking good news all the wrong places. There's only one good news. All-inclusive, there's only one all-inclusive good news, and that's the vision of oneness. Nothing else is good news. Because it leaves this mistaken premise in place. And with that mistaken premise in place, there is no such thing as good news. It's all bad news, actually. It's just relative. What we're caught up in this relativity of duality, where we only think something is good news relative to something else, which seems to be worse news. But the fact is, it's all bad news as long as this premise that there's a separate will, separate mind from God. And we're one with God, so from God, the totality of God, there's some separate mind, separate will. As long as that premise is in place, then it's all bad news. Because it does not touch at all upon our dread. Our dread remains untouched, and that's bad news. So we're in a terrible state. So if we report the news of how do I feel terrible. The dread is still there. So no matter what happens, as long as that premise is there, it's bad news, very bad news. So it doesn't matter if they catch a crook, you know, oh, they caught the crook. It's not still not good news. There is no good news except the vision of oneness. That's it. So again, why continue on with what hasn't worked? Definitely, you know that seeking the news of the world doesn't resolve your inner angst. It doesn't resolve it at all. That's something you can testify to. Everyone can testify to that. But in doing these right spiritual exercises, I can testify that I've already had several breakthroughs and have felt very close to, it's super close to this immaculately pure, super welcome good news that is all inclusive and there is no bad news anywhere to see. None. It's all good news. This is the good news. This is the all-inclusive. This is the good news that I've been waiting for. This is the all-inclusive good news that I've been waiting for. This, just as it is the all-inclusive good news that I've been waiting for. That I want, that I really want. This, all of this, just as it is the all-inclusive, great, pure and great good news that I really want. That I've really wanted to experience. This, just as it is what I've really wanted to experience. This, just as it is the all-inclusive, pure good news, without any other, without a second source, that I've really wanted. This is what I really want to experience. This is, this, just as it is the great good news that I really want to experience. This is turning the heat up. All we do in these videos is we turn the heat up. A little bit at a time. 1 degree, 2 degrees, 3 degrees. At some point, we cross a threshold where these complexes can no longer tolerate the heat. Just 1 degree more, and they say, that's it. I can't take it anymore. I gotta leave. It's not our physical body that has to leave. It's neutral. That's just neutral. It's these false perception complexes based on whim, based on whimsical desire to be greater than God. These belief system complexes, these false perceptions that have been misidentifying what the problem is. That's what leaves. They can't handle the truth. It gets too hot for them. So we turn up the heat. That's what we're doing. This, just as it is the great good news. This plant, just as it is the great good news of the vision of oneness, of the oneness. This plant, just as it is the great good news of oneness. This road, just as it is the great good news of oneness. Only the vision of oneness is good news. Only the all-inclusive, without a second, vision of oneness is the great good news. This moment is the great good news. There is no other moment. Only this moment is the great good news. This great good news is all moments. Every moment is the great good news. The great good news is totally inclusive, totally pure. There is no second good news. Only the vision of oneness is the great good news that we really want to experience. So you see, we're just clearing away the brush and everything from this, turning the heat up a little bit. Later on, we'll turn it up even more. But first, you have to kind of ease into it like this. This is the soft landing, okay? What we do is a soft landing. Ease into it. Let our mind get familiar with this. The vision of oneness is all there is to see. There is nothing else to see. The all-inclusive vision of oneness is all there is to see. There is nothing else to see. The vision of oneness, the all-inclusive vision of oneness is all there is to see. There is nothing else to see. The vision, all-inclusive vision of oneness, which includes this plant just as it is all there is to see. The all-inclusive vision of oneness, which includes this desk, is all there is to see. There is nothing else to see. The all-inclusive vision of oneness includes this plant just as it is. There is nothing else to see. This is the great good news. The all-inclusive great good news of the vision of oneness includes that head just as it is. There is nothing else to see. The all-inclusive, pure, great good news of the vision of oneness includes those flowers just as they are. There is nothing else to see. There's nothing else I need to see. There is nothing else I need to see. This is it. The great good news of the all-inclusive vision of oneness includes this dirt just as it is. And this is the great good news. There is no other great good news. There is nothing else to see. The all-inclusive, pure vision of oneness, the all-inclusive vision of oneness includes that leaf just as it is. And this is the great good news. There is no other good news. This is it. There is nothing else to see. There is nothing else to see. That stone edging, the all-inclusive, pure that it is. Includes those stone, that stone edging. Right? Includes that stone edging just as it is. And that is the great good news. There is no other good news. This is it. Just as it is, this is it. There's nothing else to see. That clump of dirt, okay, we're looking at. So, the all-inclusive vision of oneness, which is totally immaculately pure, includes that clump of dirt just as it is. And there's nothing else that needs to be seen. This is it, just as it is, this is it. Turning up the heat. Just keep turning up the heat. That is what we do here. And we know this will flush out the complexes. It will flush them out. We may be looking at a prairie and see nothing. Have a wildfire on the prairie and suddenly everything gets flushed out, right? Everything gets flushed out. So we think, nothing's happening. I'm doing these exercises, nothing's happening. Well, the flushing out is coming. You just keep turning the heat up. The more you turn the heat up, the closer you're getting to flushing out these complexes, and you will begin to discover that, oh, there goes one, there goes another. And as your days go by, more and more and more get flushed out. It's this huge, huge, huge heat wave that is flushing everything out. Bring on the heat wave. It's interesting that I love heat waves. Just love it. I'd like it to be 115. Because it feels like the intensity of this heat wave is just flushing everything out. What can tolerate this heat wave, you see? So, it's also analogous to turning heat up, melting everything down, and what is not melted remains what is true and pure. That kind of thing, too. Or all the impurities burn away, all the dross burns away and leaves the pure gold. That kind of thing. These are just all analogies, metaphors for right spiritual practice. It flushes out what can't tolerate the truth. This beautiful morning. Okay, we're talking about that. The all-inclusive, immaculately pure vision of oneness without any other includes this beautiful morning just as it is, which is the great good news that I really want to experience. There's nothing else for me to experience. So, you know, that just turned the heat up a couple of notches for sure. Reverberating, I feel a reverberation of that. So there's some complexes there that don't like that reverberation at all. They're saying, it's too loud for me. I gotta leave. Someone's ringing the bell. I can't stand it. So we'll talk about this beautiful tree right here. Okay. So the totally inclusive, immaculately pure vision of oneness includes this beautiful tree just as it is, which is the great good news that I really want to experience this very moment. There's nothing else that I need to experience. There's nothing else that I need to see. This is it. This, just as it is it. There is no other. nothing else for me to experience. So in these videos, you'll notice that we start out and we kind of do some dusting, some cleaning, kind of gradually work into it. That's how it has to happen. We turn the heat up gradually. It's a soft landing here. So we gradually turn the heat up. And as the video goes on, it begins to get more intense and more intense and more intense. Those flowers will be the subject. So this vision of immaculate purity and in all-inclusiveness, the vision of oneness. This vision of oneness without any other, without a second vision, just this one vision of oneness, totally includes all those flowers just as they are. This very moment, just as they are, which is exactly and totally what I really want to experience. This is the great good news that I really want to experience. There's nothing else I really want to experience. This is it. There's nothing else I really want to see. This is it. This, just as it is it. Maybe I'll do some video that shows you these various things as possible. I'll think about it. Yeah, I could do that. I could do that. Let me try that for us. That we look at the subject matter as I'm speaking of it, so we can really focus. That'll turn up the heat even a little bit more. Let me see if I can do that. Okay. The all-inclusive, supremely pure, immaculate vision of oneness includes these flowers just as they are, which is the great good news that I want to experience. There's nothing else that I want to experience. Just this vision of oneness. The supremely smoothed out, totally pure vision of oneness includes this tree just as it is. And this is the great good news that I really want to experience. There's nothing else I really want to experience. This just as it is it. This just as it is it. This is it. This is this. Just as it is, this is it. This is this. This is it. Just as it is, this is it. The immaculate heart of the pure presence of the all-inclusive vision of oneness includes this bunch of flowers just as it is. And this is exactly the good news that I really want to experience. be perfect and all inclusive. Vision of oneness includes these oranges just as they are. And this is the great good news that I really, really want to experience. There's nothing else that I really want to experience. This is it. Smooth, 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 vast, pure. Vision of all-inclusive oneness. Includes these flowers and plants just as they are. Just as they are. This very moment, just as they are. And this is what I truly want to experience. This is all that I truly want to experience. This is it. There's nothing else I need to experience. This is it. This is the great good news that I have been waiting for. The perfectly pure and totally smooth, seamless vision of oneness. That is all-inclusive, includes this stone edging, includes this dirt, includes these flowers, just as it is. Just as it is. And this is it. This is what I've been waiting for. This is what I really want to experience. This is here now. This is here now, and this is the great good news. The vision of oneness in its perfect purity, without any exclusion whatsoever, includes this scene of oranges, palm leaves and flowers and light in a pot. It includes all of this. Without any exclusion, it is totally included just as it is. Just as it is. And this vision of oneness that includes this just as it is exactly what I really want to experience. There's nothing else that I need to experience. This is it. The all-embracing, totally inclusive, completely pure, smoothed-out smoothness of the vision of oneness totally includes, as it is, this little flower complex. And all the little bugs and everything you see is totally included as it is. And this is the great good news that I truly desire to experience. There's nothing else that I desire to experience. This is it. Just as it is, this is it. The perfection and incorruptibility of the pure vision of oneness totally includes this flower complex just as it is. And this is what I really want to experience. And it's here right now. There's nothing else I need to experience. There's nothing else I want to experience. This is it. This smoothed out oneness that is all inclusive. This vision of oneness shows me that it includes this swaying palm branch. Just as it is, exactly as it is. And this is the great good news that I've been waiting for. There's no other good news. This is the great good news, without a second. The vision of oneness in its perfect inclusiveness includes all of this just as it is, right here, right now, always and forever. And this is the perfect great good news that I find totally welcome, and I welcome this experience of this great good news. I seek for no other good news. This is the good news. There is no other. This is it. The purity, the incorruptibility, the complete inclusiveness, the immaculate centeredness, the vast oneness of the vision of oneness reveals to me that it includes this vegetation. Just as it is. And this is the great good news that I have been waiting for. My seeking is over. There is no other good news. This is it. This is it. This, just as it is it. the one and only Vision of Oneness, without a second. In its total boundless vastness, completely smoothed out smoothness, totally includes these flowers exactly as it is. Without any exclusion or exception. And this is exactly and totally the very experience that I really want. I need no other experience. This is it. The absolute stillness. Of the total inclusiveness, without any exception, of the Vision of Oneness, totally includes all of this just as it is, and this is the great good news that I have been seeking, and now I have found it. I need to seek no longer. This is it. The heart of all purity and incorruptibility, the perfect center of all vastness, this Vision of Oneness, totally smoothed out smoothness, which is all inclusive without any exceptions, which is the only Vision of Oneness there is. This Vision of Oneness totally includes this flower, just as it is, and this is exactly and totally what I have always wanted to experience, and I'm experiencing it now. I need seek no other experience. This is it. The ever and all-inclusive Vision of Oneness, which is the pure good news. Totally includes this flower petal, just as it is, without any addition, without any subtraction. Totally includes it just as it is, and this Vision of Oneness is the experience that I've been waiting for. It is the great good news that I really want to experience. It is here now. This is it. This is it. Nothing else is it. This is it. There's only one vision of oneness, and this is it. Totally inclusive, totally pure, completely boundless, with its center everywhere, completely seamless and smoothed out. This vision of oneness totally includes all of this flower complex, just as it is. And this is truly the great good news that I want to experience. And I welcome this great good news without any other second good news. This is it. This is all the good news right here, right now. Pure, perfect, great good news. This is all that I need to experience. The heart of oneness, totality of oneness, the vastness of oneness, the smoothness of oneness, the all-inclusiveness of the vision of oneness includes this leaf just as it is. This leaf just as it is in the vision of oneness is the great good news that I've been waiting for. I need not seek any other news. Only the vision of oneness is the great good news. It's the only good news there is. There is no separate mind. There is no separate will. There's only the perfect totality of the one abiding in the pure spaciousness of the ground of being, which is the prime creator, which is God. And I am now seeing this great good news. The smoothed out vision of oneness totally includes these flowers just as they are. In this moment, just as it is. Always and forever. Eternally. And this is the great good news. All right, very great. We had this wonderful accompanying orchestra of the chainsaw to everything, which is just fine. We had the chimes, we had the birds, we had everything. See, it's all inclusive. The vision of oneness is all inclusive. There's nothing that is excluded. There is no separate mind, there is no separate will. Everything is included in the pure spaciousness. Everything is totally included in the pure spaciousness. And the atmosphere, like the atmosphere, the air, stops where this bottle begins, right? That's atmosphere. When we say pure spaciousness, we're not talking about atmosphere. We're talking about the area. This bottle is totally included in this total spaciousness, this area, for instance. In other words, the area doesn't stop where this glass is. The atmosphere stops, but not the area. Not the pure spaciousness. We're talking about pure spaciousness. We're talking about area. We're talking about the actual space of the area, not the atmosphere. When we think about space, we're thinking about atmosphere. No, we're thinking about this whole bottle is in this area, totally, within this area, right? And this area is actually totally boundless because everything is included in area, areaness, right? Pure spacious areaness is another way to put it. So this is something that people have a little bit of confusion about. What are we talking about? Not atmosphere, not air, not gaseous air, which obviously does stop there. No, we're talking about areaness. So all the atmosphere also abides in areaness, right? Pure spaciousness. Everything does. Everything, without exception, does. There is no other airiness. This airiness is infinite, boundless. Pure abstraction, zero dimensionality. That which has space for everything else, the ground of being. And we can have the vision of oneness, which gives us this meaning that everything we see is included in this forever. Everything we see is included in this boundless airiness. Very subtle, and we'll wonder, how could we possibly ever miss that? It's the most obvious aspect there is. It's totally self-evident. Totally self-evident. And yet, we are like asleep to this fact. That's why we say we're in a coma. What is totally self-evident, we're not aware of it. We say, I don't see it. Where is it? What are you talking about? Totally self-evident. Okay? So, we will continue to turn the heat up. All we're doing is we're turning the heat up on all these complexes of unawareness. Coming out of our coma, of saying that we don't see what is totally self-evident, what is totally obvious. Turning the heat up, and these complexes will go. They'll go of their own accord. And one day you'll just realize, I don't have any blocks to the awareness of the presence of pure spaciousness. Some say call it love. Judeo-Christian tradition calls it love. The other traditions call it pure spaciousness. I relate more to pure spaciousness because in the Western society, love has taken on all the connotations of the flesh, okay, which is definitely, we don't want to bring those connotations into it. So pure spaciousness, it's difficult to get wrong connotations of that. You know, it's not so easy, is it? Zero dimensionality, pure abstraction. Pure airiness, that's all. But this is also the same thing that what the Judeo-Christian tradition says, love. Jesus says, if you don't have love, you don't have anything. This love is the pure spaciousness, is the pure airiness, that which everything that arises is eternally included in. There's no exclusion of anything. No exclusion. There is no exclusionary principle of everywhereness. There is no exclusionary principle of everywhereness, of love. No exclusion whatsoever. When we talk about love in today's world, we automatically get this a body feeling, a body sensation, a feeling like, I love you, I love this, like, this makes me feel warm and comfortable. That's not what we're talking about at all. So it's easy to get off track almost instantly. I find when you use the term love, I instantly feel off track because of all the marketing and advertising that have been used to muddy up this term. But pure airiness. Zero dimensionality. The uncrystallized zero dimensionality. Then I tend to get a feeling that space is out and does not include the body thoughts at all. No body thoughts are included in that. Whereas we take love, it seems like body thoughts immediately arise because the ego has defended against that very heavily. And we don't need to battle the ego when it's heavily, heavily defended some area. Sidestep that and keep turning up the heat on the overall complex of it. Don't get caught up in tilting at windmills. We're geniuses. We're supposed to be geniuses at this. So don't get hung up on words. If some word brings up connotations that you don't feel jittery, you don't like it, because it's a lot of flesh connotations, say, okay, we'll use some other term that doesn't have the connotations. This is just being intelligent. Don't be dumb. Be smart. Be smart. Don't let anything delay you. This pure airiness, as it is right now, this is the great good news. This is the great good news. The pure airiness is the great good news, because everything is included in it already. Nothing has to happen. Nothing has to happen. Nothing has to not happen. So we're free of the world. We're free of all happenings and non-happenings. So we will continue to turn up the heat. That's all we're doing, is we're turning up the heat. Look at it that way, and that will make you feel much more willing to practice, because you just say, I'm just turning up the heat, and every amount of heat that I turn up, that's going to drive closer to driving those complexes away, those blocks, dissolving those blocks, driving the complexes away. They will flee of their own accord. I don't have to do anything except these practices. That's all I have to do. Everything else will take care of itself. Okay. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next video. That's it.